gets up in the morning, about to break a day. He jumps into his pickup, heads out on his way. He's got one who's coming. Myrtle is her name. She's a good old walker. People and the streets in his way. Rattling up that old logging road, in search of a buckskin log. A few pulls on that McCullough. She be.
Did you order an axe?
Well, it is most definitely not every day that you get this, friends.
It just isn't.
If I was an axe collector, I'd be freaking right now. That's a freaking beautiful HB 3-pounder. You know what I mean? 3-pounder. And it,
Bradley from the Gatlin Range. I decided to go with a 28-inch handle for you.
It's all about the movement, Bradley, from the Gatlians. It's all about the movement, my friend. On the burn, pal. We are on the burn. How's the family, pal? Everybody getting excited for Santa Claus? CJ, Timber, you guys been good? I talked to Santa last night. He's quite a ways away, but he's making his way. Trust me on that one. I'm tight with Santa Claus, tight with him. I made him an axe a few years ago and he still is using it. He carries it in the sleigh with him. Sometimes he's got to cut rope, so he uses the axe. Bradley, I have to share this moment with you, my friend. It's when the transformation takes place, okay? I'll show you what goes on here. The transformation, my friend. As the vodka hits the hickory. Hey, Timber, thank you again. I'm not kidding you, Timber. It's so cold out here right now. This scarf is keeping me completely warm. I love it. Thank you. And CJ.
So anyway, Timber, your the scarf. I got this heat lamp over my head too. We bought it for the dogs. Eh? It's for chickens and stuff. You know, little chicks. I use it. It keeps my head warm. And that light there. Hey, CJ, that light. Oh. It keeps Thomas off my back. He was riding me hard.
Oh, you guys, this is awesome. We're going to laugh about this for years to come. All of us. Let's put some more of this vodka on this handle here. Doesn't quite have enough yet. For the first coat. And then we're going to drop the axe head on her. And I think you should watch that process too. And I've got a fairly good fit to begin with. Which is always a treat because sometimes I'm busting away for an hour up here. I'm not kidding you. So I like to rub this in real hard, friends.
Get it in the fibers of the wood. Get it right in there. Bradley from the Gatlins. Is that what it is, Brad? Gatlins? Gatlin Range, maybe? Gatlin, yeah. Gatlin Mountain Range. That's cool. What a place, eh? Always important, friends, when you're making an axe or anything like of this nature, is get your extremities full of your whatever your preservative, whatever you're using. In this case, I'm using
Watco.
Watco. Watco Danish oil. Okay? And I'll tell Bradley. This thing's special, bud. It is. It's special, this handle. Look. Come on, talk to me about that, brothers and sisters. Aunts and uncles. Come on. Come on. Yeah, okay, it's time. Yeah, it's time. Oh my heavens to Betsy. Heavens to freaking Betsy here. Get that in there. In there, in there. Well, because I took that, the, friends, if you don't take that varnish off, you're wasting your time. You're wasting your time. Get rid of it and treat the wood. Treat it. Your axe handle will last you so long, especially if you take care of it. And friends, I gotta be honest. Listen, I can't tell you what to do. You know that. But when you get these axes, listen, Bradley, listen. Listen. You hear it? It's what you want. None of this. Okay, now, when we... Now I may... It's a little bit of space right there. I may do a little work on this handle. It doesn't alarm me too much, that little bit, though. It's on both sides. So I may knock a little of this off and get that closer. You can see it there, Bradley. You see it there? Okay, on both sides. So I want to try and straighten that out. I mean, some of this will do that. You know, some of that will take care of it. Yeah, it's closed it up. Actually, it's almost closed it right up. But it's not completely. So we'll probably end up taking a little wood off of here and getting that to seat. Remember, it's a used axe. It's been hit. That's what happens. When you hit the pole, it spreads that. Unfortunately, that's what happens. So we just have to work with it. That's all. I'll close it up. Over and out. Come on. Huh? Come on. Where's the baker's mittens? Now that's a toque. Huh? Look at that thing. Hey? Look at that nice toque. So, I just got my toques. I didn't get that many because I couldn't afford a whole bunch. But I got some. But they're sweet. They're like 20,000 thread count or something, he was saying. I've known this guy for 30 freaking years. I don't even know why I didn't think about him off the hop. But I have this style, guys, gals, women, and children. It's actually a sweet toque. It's acrylic. But it is sweet. It's really, really nice, actually, guys. Look at the design of it. It's a sweet toque. Okay? And then a neat hairstyle tonight, wouldn't you say? I would think so. Now, you guys already saw this one, okay? This is a nice toque. It's a little more relaxed. It's this style of toque, which is nice too. It's nice. Yeah, I like it. But I like this one. It's a little tighter on the head. This one here. And you can kind of wear it like that and look goofy like me. Hey, you know what I'm saying? So anyways, there's 12 of each, and I know that's hardly none at all, but we'll sell them and then maybe we can buy some more. And I got a t-shirt coming out next week. My first t-shirt coming out next week. I'll keep you informed, but yeah. So we'll see how that goes.
Over morning, good sir. How are you?
Hey guys, it's Sunday and I'm out in the shop going here because I just want to make sure that I got my ducks in a row. Now I'm putting this axe together, and of course because it's a vintage head, it's been probably hafted a few times over its time, and there's one little spot, Brad, where it, you can see it's a little bit, I don't like gaps, okay? I don't like them. It's minor, but I don't like it, okay? I don't like it at all. It just bothers me, that's all. And I think I'm gonna try and figure it out. So that's where this build is at right now. It's got beautiful fitmanship all the way around, everywhere except kind of right there and there. And then I know what it is. It's been hit. You see, it's been hit and mushroomed and pushed out. That's why. And I don't want to bang it too much. I don't want to bang the head too much. I might do a little bit of massaging in here. You know what I mean? I might do a touch of massaging here and here, and that'll be about it. But I think I'd rather work with the wood instead and drop that down on the head more. You see? Like you see here, Brad? Just take it down a little more so that it sits down, and then the wood will get fatter, you see? So that's what I think I'm going to do. I'm going to do it. Because all it's going to do is it drop it down on that shoulder more, which is actually nice. But I'm going to cut my kerf bigger. Yeah, that's where we're at, buddy. How are you guys doing today? Anyway, how's the family? It's Sunday morning. Probably a little after 9. Yeah. You got to be careful here. You do. You got to be real careful here. You can actually take too much. You have to be careful. Guys get hasty, and all of a sudden you've taken too much, and you get real mad at yourself because that's just no fun. And you can see where it's at here. You can see where it all needs to come. You see? So you just have to go real careful, is all. And only take it where it's needed. You see? Only take it where it's needed. I want it to drop down on the shoulder a little more, Bradley. You see, because it's got a real nice profile right now, real nice profile actually, but we do need to drop down a touch here, not a ton, about that much, to be honest with you. Yeah, it looks real good. So I'm going to try this again, and this is what it's all about. Like, it goes on beautifully, Brad, beautifully, but, oh, it's better. You see, I haven't even banged it yet, and I want to show you this. See that space right there? Can you actually see it there, right there, Brad? So, give it a little hit. That side closed up nice. It's looking real good actually. I may have to just give it a couple of taps because it's got beautiful halfmanship there now. Okay, bud, talk to you in a bit. Okay, Brad. You crazy Bradley guy. We'll have to see. Bradley? I got the fitmanship way better. I wasn't happy with it. Yeah, I wasn't happy.
Where's that now? So that's right about there. So that puts that. Where's our head here? That puts us right about there. So that gets us there. Okay, that's not bad. I can handle that, Bradley. Here we go. I like about a 3/4. Yeah, see, that gets it right down there. Good. More fluids. The wife made me a shake. What's happening here? I got my laptop out here, friends. And I see there's some comments coming in there. What's happening? What are we talking about over there, hey? Okay. Bradley, let's do this. I can't believe my beautiful wood carpenter's vise. I freaking love it. So we're down there on the shoulder now, partner. We are down there. This is a nice size head for this handle. It's a clobber and wedge banger, boy. It's got nice. Like it almost, like it could. You know what, the 32-inch handle, it could almost go on there, but not quite. It looked a little bit small, so this is a sweet axe. Really, a little heavier in the head. Actually, no, it's perfect. It's freaking perfect. Okay, let's go over here. I'm a little cluttered over here right now. I'm going to have to deal with this pretty darn freaking quick, if I don't say so. Oh, there was a fella asking about a mall. Have you ever seen a mall that looks like that? Doesn't that look like a freaking... Thunderbird's head? That's neat, eh? It's a 10-pounder with the old school eye. Isn't that neat? Says some stuff. I'll check it out later. That thing's big. Big. Okay. This is going on. Dun 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 dun. One hit. It's the one hit wonder. Oh yeah. Oh, it's good, Bradley. It's real good. Look at that. Talk to me about that. Oh, it's good. Okay. Let's get you over here, friends. Let's get some let's get a wedge and see what we got here. I always squeeze them together, friends. Squeeze them together so you don't peel them out, right? I know guys who put a little clamp on them. Shall we, Bradley? I say we shall. Make sure she gets centered. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Oh, I got a good feeling about this.
Look at her, buddy. So far, so good. So we got another half inch to go and she's just planted. So that means plow time. I like this part. You know what I might do with this? Because this is finesse hit. I like this. When we get to this stage, believe it or not, I like to sometimes use this. And work my way back and forth. See? See that? Right down. Right in. I like this. I really like this. Oh, Bradley. She's a good one, buddy. I like it. I really like it. Let's have a look here.
I hear the notifications coming in like mad here. Yeah, see? The old wood rasp sure is good for many, many things. I like it. Because once you hit that hickory, it's all over. Yeah, see? Right there. You can see. Once you get to it, you know you're there. Yeah. Then I customize it a bit for you. I think we might throw a couple of wedges in this one. Oh, she looks good, Bradley. Real good. This head is so sweet. Actually, this is a nice fit. This is a real nice fit. Quite tickled with it, actually. Yeah, we shall see. I'd be interested. I'd actually be interested to see, Mr. Brad, if this thing budges at all after hafting it on there like that without any wedges. I would. I'd be interested. Why don't we go clobber the old fir tree and see what happens, shall we? We don't have to hit the fir tree. That old fir tree, they're going to get cut down at some point. They've been topped and butchered. And yeah, I don't reckon she's going anywhere, my friend. No. There's our curling our wood still from our first seat. My thing is it's got the head, unfortunately, the head's been beaten, bent, and twisted, so it's actually, it's higher on one side, you'll see, right there, and there, it come out of the mold, I guess, like that, because it's, yeah, you see, it's dead center down the pipe, so that's good, that's the main thing, I like it, I really like it, it's a nice little axe, my friend, I'll do the finishing touches for you, Brad.
Hey, friends,
how are we all doing?
Gosh, so this is a brand new, this is that 850 I got. My partner gave it to me. Now, this is a brand new chain. And all I do on a brand new chain is I just put my thumb in front of the tooth. And I do one sweep on the rakers. Literally, friends. One sweep. See how the chain's loose because it's new? There we go, done. I already finished. I turned you on after. One little sweep. Just for me, it's just how I like it. Okay?
Okay, we've got our special edition Buck and Billy Ray toque on, and our Argyle sweater for those of you who like to cut in fashion. I figured I'd take my little buddy Bradley's axe out here and maybe give it a little wallop or two here and something. Let's take a look-see poo-poo, shall we? We're in the snow, the man from Snowy River. Where's our piece of wood? We can't really see much because of the snow here, you see. I think I was beating this thing up, wasn't I? I thought I was.
Friends.
You know? I thought I was beating this thing up. Maybe not. Oh yeah, here we go. Maybe this was it here. Oh yeah. There's some tough stuff. There it is. Ooh. Oh,
my. Oh, oh. I think we've got ourselves an axe here. Let's just do one more little test, Bradley. Remember, there's no wedge yet, my friend. Now, I think if that was going to go anywhere, I probably would have, eh? There's our curls. You can just see them. See them there? They're in the same spot. Up here. So what'll really set this off is a couple of those nice round wedges up top. It'll finish this axe off beautifully. I'm happy. Real happy. It's a nice axe. I like testing them before I put my steel wedges in. You know what I'm saying, friends? Why do that? I mean, yes, that's what a lot of fellas do, and it makes sense. But I like to know that before my steel wedges go in, that my axe is going nowhere. This is a beautiful axe. As I walk back with it now to the house, and I'm picturing myself walking out of the bush or walking over the tree or something, it just feels like it all the rest of mine do, my fallen axes. It feels bang on.
Bang on.
Now for some Watka. Yeah, no, it didn't move at all, Brad. Look in the light. Look at it. It didn't even budge. You don't want it. It shouldn't budge. What's, you know what I mean? The only thing with this head was actually made on an angle. You'll see like here, Brad, underneath one side's, you'll see what I mean when you look at it. It's almost like I come out of the mold with a kink in it. Some did. They're axes, right? Anyhow. Brad. The wait, my friend, was worth it. This is a beautiful HB. Complete restoration. The freaking handle. It's right up the pipe. We're going to give it some Watka right now. As a matter of fact, while you're still on, let's grab the Watka rag. The latest Watka rag. Let's give this a shake so the varnish gets in there and settles from the evening before, gets all mixed in. And let's hit it with Watka on demand. Hey, look at this, Brad. Watka on demand. Come up here, you Mr. Light. Hey. Oh. I really like this part, eh? Oh boy. Let's do the other side, shall we, friends? Remember, hit it hard. Get this stuff in there. Get it into the wood fibers. It's got varnish. I can't say that enough. Right? It's got varnish in it. So get it into the wood fibers, because what it does, friends, this is what it does. It goes into the wood fibers and it actually hardens. Varnish hardens. So it actually hardens the wood. It does. My little 28-inch banger that I've had for quite a while now, it's a hard handle. It's a really hard handle. It's actually very similar to this axe, Brad. I'll go get it. But I can't stress enough. Don't just go like this with the Watka. Don't just go. You know, and you like the looks of the shine on there, so you think, oh, that looks nice and shiny. Forget that. Rub it in hard. Do that two or three times until she's good and, you know, not, you know, staying shiny, right? Okay, hang on. Now. Here's my little axe, okay?
Hey, look at this stubby little bugger. I love this. Look at the bowl on it. I this is a special axe. But look at the handle is my point. Look at the handle. Look how careful I am with it when I'm banging wedges. I've cracked a lot of wedges with this, friends, and I've actually hit this. You can see a teeny little bit now and again. This is a freaking solid little, same handle group, friends. It's the same handle group as these VB swingers. And this is just a freaking beauty. Look at, friends, here we are. Look at the difference here. This head's a little bigger, which is fine. Look at that little bugger. It's a stout little bugger, but I'll bet you it's probably the exact same weight. Well, I know it is, as a matter of fact. Isn't that beautiful, friends? Oh, they're snuggling. Watka. I hit it. I always hit this thing with the Watka. Look at it. Oh, macaroni and cheese mixed in. Oh, I love this stuff, boy. Look at that handle. Oh, this handle's actually getting better with time. I'm not kidding, it is. You keep the Watka rolling to it, friends, or whatever you're using, just keep it going to it. Look at that. Look at that. This handle's solid as a rock. I love this. I love this axe. I even give the head a little wipe once in a while. I like my tools, eh? Okay, Bradley, you've got yourself a situation here, my friend. Over and out,
Brad. So this is the interesting thing. I want you to wrap your mind around this for a second, okay? Now these handles, okay? Here's another one here. Okay, there's no, they're bone dry, okay? Nothing's been soaked. I changed my thinking right away when I started making axes, okay? There was people talking about, oh, soaking their heads in this and soaking their handles in this and doing all this and that. And that's fine. That's groovy. I get it. But if you swell something up with something, oil, linseed, whatever it is, it can dry out. Right? It can dry out. So if you swell something up, then you haft your axe. Okay, so you do your hand work and you seat your head on there. Well, you've seated it on a swollen head. So you've actually left yourself room for shrinkage and a loose head. That's how I see it. Okay, so I seat my stuff dry. Actually, what I do is I actually burn it even before. I suck every freaking bit of moisture out of it I can. More, I burn it even. I heat it up. I'm not kidding. That's what I do. Okay? So, that when it goes on, it's completely bone dry. There's nothing, there's no water in it at all. Then I seat my head. Well, guess what happens when you walk into a room with a bit of moisture in it or take it outside? What's it going to do? Exactly. It's going to swell. It's going to take on its surroundings and become a better axe. It just is. That's what happens to wood. So that's my thinking. That's just me. And I'm not saying don't soak your heads or don't change what you've been doing. But friends, I work an axe. Do you know what I'm saying? I work my axes. I beat the crap out of them, actually. So, you know, to make a nice axe and send it off or hang it or do something, that's a different story. But if you're working them, you don't want to. Okay, so anyways, you guys get the point. I'm rambling. But now that I've seated it dry, I've got glue in there. So I don't put any wedges in until that glue's the next day, till the glue's dry. Okay, that's just what I do. But now when you put a little bit of, say, Watka in the top, okay, watch what happens. It sucks, not so much the hickory. The hickory as well on a slower level, but that wedge is a different wood completely, eh? It's a different kind of wood. It really sucks up the wood. Like, I'll show you one. This will be interesting. Watch this. Let me just hang this axe here. It should just hang there. Yeah. I want to show you something, friends. I'm serious. Watch this. I'll get a piece that I don't really... Here's one here. Here's one here. Now, watch. Watch this.
Okay, it would be nice if some came out, wouldn't it? There it is. Look. Look what happened. Look at... It completely disappeared. Look it. Friends, look. Look it. Watch again. Come on. Watch it. Can you guys see that? It's gone. These wedges suck up moisture like crazy. Especially in the top grain. It just drinks it. Watch. Look at it. You can almost see it disappear. So you guys understand what I'm saying. I know I'm just trying to get Mr. All Scientist on you. But look. Look at this. It's completely gone. Look. So that's my point. So it's swell. So this axe, all my axes, I'm going to be really, really surprised if you guys get any movement on my axes at all for a long time. if ever. Okay? Now, now that I've turned into a scientist with an Argyle guess, a vest on and a scarf. Now, that's important. If I had a pipe, you'd really be in trouble. And you know it, and I know it. Okay? So that's just my thinking, friends. Okay? So, you know... again, I'm not saying soaking them in a solution for 24 hours, the whole axe head. I'm not saying that's wrong. That's totally not what I'm saying. That sounds kind of neat, actually. It would make the axe handle quite a bit heavier, is what it would do. I think HB or somebody like that does that. Wetterlings or somebody. But I don't do that. I want my axe heads to stay on. So, anyway, that's that, Bradley. I'm almost thinking, Brad, just because of the look of this axe... It needs more Watka. I can feel it in the handle. I'm almost thinking, Brad, that I finish up the tops of these. Usually, I chamfer them out. I may not do that here. I may not do it. I quite like it. I like the fact that this is... Oh, look at this, Bradley. Look. Look here. See this? It's out over top. It's mushroomed. This one is too, but mainly this one. It always seems to be one side a little more than the other. I'm freaking stoked with this axe. Freaking stoked with it. It's going to bang wedges like nobody's business. Great big pole on her. Brad, I got to move on to the next axe, but I'm telling you something, brother. I love you and your family. CJ Timber. Natasha? Over that time. Bradley? I very much enjoyed this time we shared together here today. This is where I hate putting wedges in my work.
I do. I hate it. I do.
I don't hate it. That's a strong word. I like it, actually, but I know the benefits it gives the axe. That's why I like it. And what I'll do here is I'll double up because I'm going to leave this height like this. I like it. I really like it, actually, Brad. And this is why. I want you to take a good look at this. See your left? See how it's hooked right over top? That's a good thing. I don't even know what to say, Brad. I don't know what to say. It's got... Well, I know. I know exactly where it's going to sit. It's going to sit right there where all my other axes sit. This is a freaking beauty. Look. There it is. What can I tell you? Dead center. Oh. It's gorgeous, buddy. It is. It's gorgeous. fitmanship worked out really nice.
Yeah, it's a beauty. Brad and family, love you guys. Timber and CJ, thanks so much for the goodies. My scarf and my sheet. I should say my lampshade, really, shouldn't I, CJ? Hey, bud? Timber, thanks again for the scarf. Natasha, thanks for being a good woman to these boys and take care of them. I'm sure Bradley will look after all of us. He's a good man. Thanks, friends. Talk to you soon. And Merry Christmas.